Welcome to the Denim and Sweats podcast. My name is Irvin Castellanos, and here at DNS, we review pop culture 1 year at a time. This is episode 4, and I'm here back again with the homies. Who do we got?
Thanks for having me, man. It's good to be here. It feels like a place I know very well. This is Nacho Nova. Hello. Thanks, man.
Hey, Nacho.
Hey, man. Thanks for having me.
Nacho, I feel like there's someone else hanging out here with us. Who else do we got?
Let me look around here. Let me look around this room. Ah, there we go. Right in this corner is my famous wife.
Your friendly neighborhood Jessica. Hey, everybody.
Hey, Jessica de Santiago, also chilling here at the You Guys Are My Friend studios in beautiful East Austin. Or in El Paso. We don't know.
It's true. We'll leave the light on for you. That's my catchphrase I made.
Oh, I'm really happy to have you guys back on the show. I feel like we've got some unfinished business. You know, man, I was thinking as I was looking back at the first three episodes that I've recorded, I said, me and Nacho did the first episode, but I was mistaken. I thought that you got to pick the year, but as a Denim Sweats listener pointed out, that was actually a poll result from Twitter.
Yeah, man, I had to go to HR for this.
And I had to fight for your...
Yeah. Since it's out in the open, I went to HR. I reported you for misrepresenting the facts, you know.
Yeah.
This is a pretty corporate thing that we do here, and I just want to do it by the book. So.
I hate it. Denim and Sweats had to get fucking mandatory training, you know, on like how to identify being an issue in the workplace. this has cost us a lot of money, but you know, it's something that we have to do to make sure that we get the lawyers off our hands. So.
Hey, it takes something, another catchphrase of mine, it takes, dream work to make the team work.
Oh.
No, the other way around. It takes teamwork to make the dream work. I made both of them up.
Oh, you're also the head of DreamWork Studios, so I feel like you're just giving yourself a little plug there.
Yeah. I mean, check out Food Fight on 3D in movie theaters this summer.
I can't wait for that movie. Yeah, man. So, you know, it's only fair, that I feel like we get our own episode where you get to pick the year and you get to pick what we're going to talk about.
Well, thank you, man. I appreciate the opportunity. I do have a speech ready.
Looks like the Declaration of Independence.
Jesus has been good to me. So good to me, baby.
All right.
You get the man upstairs, man.
Yeah, my boy JC, send him up, send them bad boys up to him.
Currently seen right behind him with his right hand over his shoulder. What is such a consulting him?
Yeah, he knows he's giving me a shoulder. Jesus Christ. Shoulder massage.
Oh, yeah. Also, not to be confused with a soldier massage, which, you know,
it's true.
We've all gotten.
Yeah, it's true. Well, you got to support the troops, right? Come
on. You have to. I mean, if we don't support them, who will?
Yeah, exactly right. So I appreciate the opportunity to choose the year. I did a lot of soul searching, went out in some long walks out into the wilderness. Mm-hmm. Didn't come back for days. Jessica was worried.
He disappeared. I heard that there was a missing persons report out for you.
Oh, geez, I didn't know that part. I apologize if anyone from the media is listening. I'm back at home.
Yeah. I think that's a felony, bro. False reporting.
It's like whatever the search parties cost, they're gonna make me pay for it.
Yeah, it's like when you get fucking sick and you're like, don't put me in the helicopter. That shit's like $75,000.
Yeah, exactly right. Like, can I just get an Uber? Except not Uber, because I don't support them because they hire sexual predators.
Oh God, I was gonna say, you know what? That's a pretty good idea. Like. All right, pay the Uber, which is like fucking $6 to the hospital, plus the $200 cleaning fee for all the blood in the back seat, versus the $75,000 bill.
Mm-hmm. Exactly right. And those guys have insurance, I hope.
Yeah.
Or Scotchgard,
but they're predators, so now I can't take them. Well, how am I supposed to get to the Volstead now?
Right, Austin.
Oh, yeah.
So that's,
do they still exist?
Oh, hell yeah, man. That's the only one I take. And they love me. I must have a good rating or something.
Oh.
I love them. It's mutual. Hello. Hello, right, Austin.
69 stars.
I got a solid 4.20 rating.
All the comments are the same.
Yeah.
It's just the smoke emoji.
Exactly. Yeah, a couple of eggplants.
Oh, yeah,
a couple of hot dogs.
Yeah, and like the raining one and then the umbrella afterwards.
Mission accomplished. That's what we in the biz call mission accomplished.
And then the clown face for some unknown reason.
That's what we say at DreamWorks. without further digression.
Yes, sir.
I did a lot of soul searching, and the year that I would like to time travel to today, and we don't necessarily have to come back because this is a damn good year.
It's a good year.
The year is the year of our Lord Jesus Christ, 1998.
The year of the tiger.
Whoa.
It is the year of the tiger.
How many different animals get years?
It's not that many. It's like maybe 14. It's a strange number. I'm not really sure.
So we got the dragon, the tiger,
the dog.
Yeah, the liger.
The rooster.
Uh-huh.
Like that song from Alice in Chains.
Yeah. What else? The meatball. What are the other animals?
I think the sloppy Philadelphia.
The capital city goofballs.
I know I'm the rat.
Yeah.
And that's not a commentary on my character.
Yeah, I mean, they call you Johnny Tightlips, if anything. You're no rat.
I would hope not. Come on, man.
You know what? That reminds me, shout out to the secondary podcast, Eat My Shorts, a Simpsons podcast. Check it out. Me and Nacho just launched that to take away every other Simpsons reference you will ever have to hear on this podcast or in your daily conversations with us.
And you know what's funny? I don't know. I do a podcast separately on my own in my own time.
Shout out to You Guys Are My Friends.
Yes. Hello, You Guys Are My Friends. Hello down there. When I say down there, I mean down there in the ratings.
Yeah, because clearly this is the number one show in all of podcasting.
I saw it up there on the charts.
Yeah. Eh?
But, you know, true. Like the Simpsons podcast, it's already got listeners. It's got social media followers. And it's like it's fucking eclipsing my podcast like crazy.
Yeah, it's almost as if, for whatever reason, us talking about, like, the most popular cartoon in the history of the world is giving us clout.
it's a mystery to me.
It's a mystery to me, too, man. We're going to have to ask the audience and have a half-season episode later to find out it was Maggie.
Exactly right, okay, and that's not a cop out.
That's Simpsons joke of the podcast.
All right, we'll leave them here in 2018, and then we can go time travel, man.
1998. So, all right, Jess, Nacho, let's get into the Wayback Machine and go to the future, all the way back to 1998. All right, we're here.
All right.
Hold on. Let me turn on my iMac real quick.
Hey, man, you got to turn off the safety lock, too. I can't get out.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's because the machine just wants to keep hearing all this dope-ass dance music.
It's true. Well, I think I like hotboxing the time machine.
Yeah. I think the time machine likes it, too.
Well, it is sentient, man.
Yeah.
Which is
sometimes,
a trip.
You know, I'm sure there's going to be a year where the thing just fucking takes us wherever it wants.
Hey, real quick. This is a digression. You don't even have to answer it. You can just give me a hand signal.
Okay.
Did you back in 2018, did you hear about this guy a couple days ago that got a scrotum transplant?
Yeah, I did hear about
that. That sucks, man, right?
But he didn't get his testes transplanted. Because,
he kept them?
Yeah, so apparently there's a concern that, like, the he would be ejaculating the other man's DNA.
A concern.
Yeah. My wife. Oh my god, it's fucking thank you for reminding me of that. I was like, that's one of the weirdest fucking stories I've ever seen.
It is.
So he didn't get a full scrotum transplant.
Jesus,
but he did
Christ.
Get a new penis.
Well, there you go.
Yeah.
That's
so who was this?
Some man back in 2018.
Yeah, some guy named, I don't know, Irvin Castellanos. No relation. Also, I'm bedridden for the next 2 months.
Yeah. He's not going to be able to get any sun, or you're going to have to cancel your bikini waxes, man.
Yeah. Well, you know, that's not a thing that I follow through anyway.
Cancel,
I mean,
that
living here in Austin.
Yeah, exactly right. Oh, yeah, you're right. You're right. Yeah, we're free. Free to be me.
Ourselves. So, yeah, dude, I did hear about that scrotum transfer back in the before we got in the time machine. That was pretty crazy. How did you hear about it? You just read about it?
My dad told me, actually.
He was very excited.
Yeah. It was like, I don't know how the hell he's doing
it. He asked you what medical insurance he has.
Well, actually, out of the blue. He's like, what's a good way to treat a new dick? Like, Dad, I don't know.
And then he immediately wanted to answer his own question.
Yeah, nicely.
Can I do this? Yeah, nicely. Oh, man. The crazy things that are happening in the future. Yep. In 1998, none of this shit would have even probably been available.
Couldn't even imagine. No, yeah. That's science fiction.
The one of the things I heard about that was, I guess, like news in 98 that's kind of related to that was like most of the countries made an accord that they would ban human cloning, because this is around the time that people were trying to fuck with that. And I guess that kind of led into like the whole stem cell controversy later on too. So
yeah, I remember that.
You know, we're going to create our own vision. Oh, there's your Marvel Avengers tie-in. Like, we're going to create our own sentient fucking android made of clone cells. I don't know.
That's something that the villain would say.
I know. I got real evil saying that.
I could see like the lighting changing here. You had like the electricity.
I had a giant smirk.
you were tenting your fingers.
Yeah, I lit my like my fire. I just became like embattled in flames.
I don't mean to guess at your motives. But,
I laughed maniacally, and somehow your viewpoint of me like went all the way to the top of the sky, and you're just seeing me like shake my hands up in the air. Oh my God, where are we?
This is 1998, man. This is the kind of stuff that is possible here.
It's true. Villainy. Like,
world domination. Conquest.
So, you know, being that this is a special episode where we get to talk about 1998, because as requested by the great Nacho Nova. So what's up with 1998, man? Tell me about it.
So, I mean, if you want to start from scratch, scratch Rooney, as we used to say in 1998. Oh, by the way, let me go ahead and relieve that.
Yeah.
So I'm on the planet Earth, as you may have guessed. I am in El Paso, Texas, home of the Whopper. This is a little town over on the west end of Texas, which is a state in America.
Texas.
Listen, I'm getting into some crazy details here. but I was about to head into high school. This is the year where my last year of middle school, heading into high school, leaving childish things behind.
Yeah, you know, ignoring your old friends and like getting like newer friends.
It's true. Hanging out with the kids that have the motorcycles.
Are part of the plot line, yeah. You started wearing like some sort of like dog necklace, like with the spikes.
Yeah, and the army fatigues.
Yeah.
Started doing a lot of whittling.
Yeah. Okay, that's a good picture. You're fucking, you're going through that change from child to adolescent. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the next 4 years would shape your life. Okay.
Yeah, I got my first collared shirt this year.
Ah, was it pot? Or no. Those weren't cool at the time.
You know, I tried, you know, I never really got there. It was just kind of wilted. Like, remember when Bugs Bunny would flex and his arms would turn into noodles?
Yeah. One of the greatest comic bits. Second greatest, when they would flex and they would suddenly have massive muscles.
Yeah, like Popeye.
Yeah.
Like he'd flex and there'd be like his, it would turn into like a big battleship, you know?
This came out maybe a couple years before, but in Space Jam, I feel like when they all drank Michael's secret juice or secret stuff, they all just like fucking gained like immense strength. Do you remember that? Like they all, I don't know, they got superhuman looking. Then they were going to face the Monstars.
Well, I do remember, but tell me about Lola.
Oh, Lola Bunny, one of my first crushes. All right, we gotta let that go. 96, man.
Yeah, it's true. I mean, if she exists at this point, it's in your own fan fiction.
So, okay, so you were going into high school, right? You said?
Yeah.
Seventh, eighth grade, going on ninth grade.
They were the Wonder Years.
So, shit, What were you doing, Jess? You were, I feel like I was in fourth grade going into fifth grade. What about you?
I guess so. Same thing, right?
Yeah.
Fifth grade?
I wonder if our cultures meshed. Like, were we still doing the same shit, dude? Like, were you playing your Pokemon, or did you have a Tamagotchi in middle school? I feel like we did.
I definitely had a Tamagotchi. Did you have a Tamagotchi?
You did have a Tamagotchi?
Oh, for sure.
Did it die?
My aunt from California came to visit one year and gave both me and my brother.
I had the Digimon version also, and you could hook them up together and they would battle each other.
Oh, I remember that.
And you had to feed it and I don't know, exercise it and shit.
Digimon was the original ripoff of not only Pokemon, uh-huh, but Tamagotchi.
Yeah.
Forgot that.
They just ripped everything off, man.
That's fucked up.
Yeah, man, I hate it.
That's like the, that's a damn shame. I did have a Tamagotchi. I do remember attaching it to my keys, whatever fucking key I had.
I attached it to my backpack.
Yeah.
But then, people would fuck with it because all your friends had one.
But mine was always covered in shits and, I would forget about it and it would be dead, Yeah. Remember they died? At some point you would just turn around and my damn animal died.
Oh, no. Did you guys ever, did you have a Pokemon game at that point? Because... Pokemon Red and Pokemon Blue, I feel like, shaped our childhood, not only with the game you would play and literally take it everywhere, but also the cartoon. So, did anybody have that at the time? I know I played it on the bus going to school.
Oh, good old Pokemon. he had it for Game Boy?
Would you guys start with? I think I started with a Charmander, and then the other choices were Bulbasaur and Squirtle.
I borrowed my friend's, because we were talking about this before the podcast. This may have been the period where I got my own Game Boy finally.
Uh-huh.
But my friend Steven, who does the You Guys Are My Friends podcast with me a lot, he and his brother had the red and the blue version.
Mm-hmm.
So I borrowed their cartridges. So I could, play and then build.
And they're like, yeah, sure, dude. Dude, put in all the work for me. And then I get back, better and stronger Pokemon. Because, a big fucking nuisance of that game is, having to just fucking all the time battle people to, gain strength and shit.
Yeah, a lot of grinding. But, they were nerdos like me. But, when I would borrow the cartridges, the levels for their characters would be way more advanced. I'm like, oh Jesus,
you're kind of lost.
In the time that I played, I never got the characters that high.
Yeah,
not in Pokemon.
That's the bane of my existence. Leveling up Pokemon and finding out secrets. Did you play that, Jess? Or were you up to in fourth, fifth grade?
I did play it, but I don't remember any of the leveling up
because
I never did level up.
Oh shit.
Fourth and fifth grade.
Fucking popular trends and shit.
I got my first B in fourth grade.
A bead?
Bumblebee?
B. Grade B. My first B.
Oh, damn. She's saying she was so fucking smart that she never, ever made anything below an A.
Or was it your first passing grade?
Oh.
it was my first low grade.
Oh, shit.
In the fourth grade?
Can't relate.
Yeah. Was it a big deal? Was everyone...
Yeah, my dad.
Jeez, sounds like my dad.
Jesus.
That's what I remember.
Getting a B and getting treated like a butthole for it. B for butthole.
In fourth grade, all you want to do is fucking just read books anyway.
Exactly.
That's what I was doing. That or playing Pokemon.
Yeah, I remember, moving to high school, getting my first collared shirt, objecting to it because it was just you wear t-shirts as a kid. Who the fuck cares? I remember this is when I was too cool for school. This is when I started becoming the definition of too cool for school, you remember how they would give you the book covers to cover your textbooks up with?
Yeah, yeah. Here's, you'd switch them?
Here's my fucking trick. Fucking turn that shit around, and then just draw on it. You know what I mean?
That was actually one of my favorite things, when you would, have to be, the fucking teacher would stop class, right? And they're like, all right, everyone has to, go and get a book cover or cover up their book, before we really start using them. And everyone that was cool would flip it around.
Yeah, exactly right. Or here's another cool thing. You get some paper from, a paper shopping bag. you know, you'd unfold it at the seams, you'd tear apart the seams, and then you would just take that brown paper shopping bag, fold that over your book, you know? There
oh,
you go.
Shit. I just threw my book in the trash.
Whoa! You must have been the fucking top of the cool heap, man.
No, I was drawing dumb shit on my covers. And for sure, putting that weird S that everyone did elementary school just over and over and over.
You remember you did the lines?
I can still do it right now. I can do it right now.
This try it out, because I would like to see that before the next couple minutes.
You know, I'm very interested to see this because there's a form that you have to do this with. Like, yeah. there's a system.
Oh, you did it backwards.
Whoa.
Oh, it happens.
She did it.
That was so goddamn fast. Yeah, there you go.
Well, how the fuck did we all learn about that?
I don't know. Isn't
random?
That weird?
Yeah.
Oh, if you wanted to get fancy, you would close it.
I would connect it. I would connect it because I was an OCD.
And I would make a chain out of it.
Dude, what, you just like do S?
Yeah. No, I would just stop at SS. No, just
okay, I'm going to report this podcast to the government.
Oh, not my government.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay, they're not going to do anything about it. They're probably going to give you a medal, man.
Yeah, so that's me in a nutshell, fucking being a little dweeb. Oh, probably watching Wishbone, you know?
Oh, yeah, I remember that. And because, you know, Wishbone the dog was also the same breed of the dog that they had on Frasier. It made me want one of those little Jack Russell Terriers.
Oh, God, me too. Also, it made me want to go on adventures with my dog. Like, you know, like be the main... character from a particular book, like Wishbone.
Oh, okay. I thought you were talking about Winnie the Pooh.
No, it's a stoner reference.
Wishbone or Pooh?
Both.
Technically. Yeah. Hey, this year, speaking of which, I just remembered this is the first year, this is the year 1998 where I got my dog, my first dog, Bobby.
Was he named after Bobby's World?
I wish. That was a good show, which I, from our research, I understand came to a conclusion this year.
What kind of puppy was Bobby?
He was an old man dog. He was a poodle, a black Rasta poodle.
Rasta man.
Because he would grow the, you know, he would grow the dreads.
He'd paw the duchy.
But that poor dog, man, some old lady, she died. And then, like, her family wanted to get rid of the dog, like, just fucking take it to the shelter and have it murdered.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh, no, hey. No.
You were just, happened to be in the house.
Hey, let me go ahead and...
taking her other possessions.
Yeah, I had my big burlap sack, and I was filling it with pearl necklaces.
Yeah, and you had a, just a, like, a black cloth just covering your eyes, and you had two holes in it.
These are my younger years, man. I've lived a troubled life. I got a dog that year. That was fun.
That's pretty cool. My first dog was a American Eskimo, and if you know me and you've seen pictures or met my dog Lila is what's the equivalent term, like granddaughter. Anyways, I've always had a dog that looks like that since I was like fucking five. So I had this like cute little American Eskimo, like furry, puffy little white dog. So that's kind of like a very, what would you say that? Like the antithesis of the old man dog that you got?
Mm-hmm.
Did you have a puppy at that time or a kitty, Jess?
I had no pets until I was like 16 years old.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
No pets allowed,
no pets,
man.
Except
a pet. Oh, yeah, the Tamagotchi. And any particular guy that you had your fancy?
So that was I guess that was where we were in 2020, jumping the gut here, 1998.
Whoa, man, whoa. So that's what we were up to. I'm trying to think of, now that we are in this year, what other things maybe happened that we probably didn't realize at the time because we were fucking kids or didn't realize the importance of it. But I don't know, what news events do you think were a big deal in that year?
Yeah, absolutely. I grew up in the kind of household where I'm really not sure why my father enforced this.
Uh-huh.
Excuse me, but there were certain things which he coined or he deemed to be, quote, mandatory viewing. This is what he called it. It was very few things.
Like everyone in the family had to watch this together?
It was basically, he wanted to watch it, and we had to watch it with him.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean? So it was the Olympics, National Geographic specials on PBS, and like important news stuff, you know what I mean? So one of the important news things, and you know, at this point, I was 14 years old, and he didn't enforce anything, you know? He was doing his own thing.
Here, okay. Right? But you've gained autonomy at that age already.
Well, at that point, he had already installed that little fucking prison guard in my head. Do you know what I mean? So it's like, okay, I have to watch the news. I have to pay attention to the news. So at this point, the big scandal was Bill Clinton was getting impeached for not having sexual relations with that woman.
Which later turned out that he did have sexual relations with that woman, Miss Lewinsky.
Yeah, isn't that weird how he says that woman? He's sort of like, she's not even a person.
And then he calls her Miss Lewinsky.
Yeah, like, okay, I guess I may have heard of her name, maybe.
I think even as a kid.
A cigar in
her
vagina.
Oh! What? Really?
Maybe.
Maybe. That's my Bill Clinton impression.
Well, since we're all doing it, this feels like a good opportunity to bring it bring up a segment idea. Grandma, this is a segment. This is called Who Does the Best Bill Clinton Impression?
I can't even think of any quotes he says.
Just the
sex one?
No, hold on.
Okay, this is Jessica's.
Here we go.
Jessica's Bill Clinton.
Dennis, that's exclusive.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
Yeah, okay.
That's pretty fucking good.
And I know who you're doing. I know exactly who you're doing.
All right, now we got, let's see what we Nacho has here on the Bill Clinton impression.
All right, let me go ahead and get my diaphragm.
Stretching out. He seems to be stretching one particular part of his body more than others.
This is my diaphragm. This is my sacral chakra. Ah, all right.
Transplanted.
Wait, no, that's not good. Hold on.
That's pretty good. That was like a Nixon a little bit.
That was a Nixon.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman. Wait, that sounds like a fucking old man.
That's totally it. That's totally
it's because I need to drink some water. Me, yeah. I did the vocal warmers, but not the...
Yeah. Opens up a can of water. Click.
Hey, we'll do yours real quick.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. I've never heard Bill Clinton speak in my life, and I'm not very familiar with it, but I'm going to give it a little shot. I did not... I can't do it either. Miss Lewinsky.
There you go. I did not have sexual... Fuck it.
All right, let's all do it at the same time.
One, two, three.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
Miss Lewinsky. That was pretty fucking good. SNL, hit us up.
Good.
I mean, you know, Daryl Hammond, he's all right. But, you know, I think we got a pretty good Clinton.
I feel like my Bill Clinton is very similar to Forrest Gump.
Oh.
Well, do your Forrest Gump real quick.
What's the Forrest Gump like?
Johnny.
Well, I think your Forrest Gump is your Bill Clinton.
Oh, no, really?
Johnny.
See, that's my Forrest Gump.
Okay.
Lieutenant Dan. I don't know how to do him.
Sorry, messed up your Black Panther party.
There you go. That's a good one.
Let's just keep doing quotes from Forrest Gump.
Go back to Greenbow, Alabama.
Stupid. It is stupid.
Yeah. the guy that announces him on the fucking Washington Monument, Forrest Gump.
What the hell are you remembering? What are you remembering?
The guy that announced him, like, before they made him, like, talk and shit. And he's like, the wall in fucking Vietnam.
Oh, yeah, okay, I remember that, yeah.
Shout out to Vietnam.
I hope they're doing okay.
Yeah.
In 1998, who can tell?
Not us, we're little kids.
No, we barely even had nothing. TV, man. We had to light a fire inside of a cardboard box for TV.
And wearing, like, fucking gloves that are, like, halfway cut off. and just like warming up by it.
Oh yeah, the little fingerless gloves. Yeah, bring. I brought them back in the mid-2000s.
You had all your possessions like wrapped up in a towel, and like you hung that towel on like a stick.
My little bindle, yeah. baby's first bindle.
Yeah, that was the hottest toy of '98. Move over, Furby.
Oh, Furby was '98, huh?
Yeah,
those things were crazy.
So, did you hear that? Like, the reason that it was kind of crazy is that like it had a chip in it, so like it reacted to like other Furbies, and apparently it was such an issue that like there was like a security clearance concern that like it was gonna like record like confidential conversations. So like some of them weren't allowed in like government buildings. Oh, for
they
a
had
minute.
To, they have to have a ban on Furbies specifically, yeah, right?
Specifically because of that. And then you know later on there was a ban on furries. From what I've heard, except in Austin, I've seen a lot of furries around.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Hey, okay. We need to do a little street journalism one day, back in when we're in 2018, and check that out.
So I think we went on a bit of a tangent, but
yeah, let's turn the whole conversation to furries.
Yeah. So I believe what we began would later turn into a fucking impression off. January 17th, 1998, the Drudge Report breaks the story about the U.S. President Bill Clinton having an alleged affair with Monica Lewinsky, and that would lead to the House of Representatives' impeachment of him. So beginning of the year, man, fucking right after New Year's. Sorry, dude, you can't even get to MLK Day, but here's a scandal for you.
Yeah, second term, and it was the impeachment, which was a big deal. And you know what? It makes sense to me that the Clinton was the guy that got impeached. Because as we all know, the Clintons are a crime family. That's just the news.
It's true. You know, oh, yeah. I believe the term, and this is shout out to Whatever You Want podcast, too. Lock her up.
Lock her up. There you go.
Send her to jail. That was pretty catchy. I like that one.
Convict that woman of a crime.
Yeah. Are you allowed to execute people at a local jail? No talking. So that shit went on all year, dude. It wasn't until like late December that the House of Representatives forwarded articles of impeachment against Clinton. So he was the second president ever to be impeached, but I don't know. I don't even know what happened. What happened with that?
It wasn't. Or I don't know. He only got halfway impeached, basically.
Oh, a half peach.
What were you gonna say, Grandma?
I just don't understand how he got impeached so quick. But President Trump is still like they haven't even started.
Oh,
because it's a Republican Congress, and they're some of them are complicit, some of them are involved. Nobody wants to lift a finger because he's on their team and they're not going to fuck with someone on their team.
Yeah, Denim and Sweats politics minute.
It's just, it's like sports. It's the sportification of politics. You know what I mean?
So, yeah. Clinton.
but he got impeached. It wasn't even that big a deal. He was allowed to serve out the entire term.
Yeah, they didn't give a shit. Seriously. I'm sure everybody was like giving him high fives and shit.
Who was not? I mean, I'm sure there were some people not rooting for him. I know
Mitch McConnell is probably there,
but the big frown already,
just looking like a like an old bullfrog.
Jesus Christ, man! There's anybody who's looked more like a reptile?
Yeah. He's the definition of like the reptilian like patient X. He created like this fake YouTube race that you hear about on random videos.
Jesus, yeah, you should put him on the YouTube videos, huh?
Yeah. What else happened that year?
He does look like a reptile.
Doesn't he?
But yeah, Clinton was fine.
Yeah, that's just him, like, looking.
Seriously.
Like, he hasn't done nothing to his face.
Yeah, like, you ever fed a hot dog to a turtle?
Have you ever...
I oppose to this.
Have you ever thought about the fact that, like, the way that someone would draw a smiley or a frowny face never ever looks like anyone, but it actually looks like Mitch McConnell? Yeah. Like, his mouth is literally making a frown. How is it going that far? It's a half moon.
Do you remember that Muppet Beaker that was like, beep, 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 beep.
Yeah.
He's like that guy.
Except with, like a 90% tinier mouth. Like, that mouth is, like an inch in diameter. Yeah.
Like a tiny conservative mouth on a Muppet.
Hmm. Well, you know what? This is a Trump show. I need to reestablish.
Yeah, we don't need to get too sexual here. Talking about Muppets with small mouths.
Right. Okay. So a lot of politics going on in 1998, like every other year. What else happened that year? Okay. What do you know about this shit? You want to know how fucked up this is and how dumb this makes me? I first heard about the Unabomber through an SNL episode with, like, Will Ferrell playing him.
Yeah, I remember
but,
that.
But the Unabomber, Theodore Kaczynski, pled guilty this year, and he accepted a sentence of life without parole. So this wasn't just a comedy sketch? This was actually, like, a murder spree, or what the fuck?
Yeah, do you remember how a few weeks back in Austin there was the guy that was bombing people?
Right.
The only thing in my brain that I could compare it to was the Unabomber from, I guess, 20 years ago now.
So this should happen through mail as well?
Yeah, he was mailing... Oh, Jesus Christ, I couldn't give any specifics. I think he was actually mailing, like, people in journalism, schools. He was mailing schools,
so
I know
that. He's a
wacko. Yeah, like, he had a personal vendetta. I really don't remember his specific problem.
Hmm.
He lived in a shack way out in the middle of nowhere. And
like, oh, my God, this is, like, movie-worthy shit. Did they ever make a movie out of it?
Jesus, I don't know why they haven't, because they really should have.
Yeah, it's because we need more Adam Sandler comedies.
Well, yeah, yeah.
On Netflix.
You guys ever see that thing where he makes the shoes? Oh, my God.
The cobbler? Oh, my God.
What?
Yeah, and you know what?
That's his gimmick?
Yeah.
And I thought it was going to be about a peach cobbler. That's why I tuned in.
Yeah, this is a pie show, first of all.
Yeah, I feel like I was misdirected. That's a little...
this is blatant false advertising.
Yeah, a little dishonest. Okay.
Last Simpsons reference, I promise.
Yeah, I mean, come on. That was a bonus. That was the bonus feature for the premium subscribers.
Yeah, it's true. They're patron subscribers. Okay.
Thank you.
What else happened? Okay, here's the thing that fucking shows you how ancient this sounds. In May, the Galaxy 4 communication satellite failed. It left 90% of the world's pagers without service. How did all the drug dealers do their deals?
That's true. I wonder if there was, like, a spike in murders because doctors didn't get, like, back to the hospital.
Yeah. Well, they were all having ridiculous romantic storylines like we've seen in ER, so...
Yeah, exactly.
They don't actually help patients. There's, like, other, like... They let the nurses do that.
Well, yeah, they let the nurses, like, declare someone dead.
Yeah. This person's still breathing. Yeah. And then you just hear, like, the dramatic music. It made me want to go to the hospital.
Whoa.
I was like, maybe I'll fall in love with this pretty nurse.
So you're, like, getting the accident, punching yourself in the face.
Yeah.
Gotta go to the hospital.
Yes, as you can see, I was the originator of the Jackass genre. And, you know, I was filming myself because I was trying to get on ER, you know, and to show off my stunt acting abilities.
It's true, man.
So I need to get some money out of that cut. So MTV, what's up?
Yeah, for any lawyers are listening in the Austin, Texas area, give them a holler.
And, give me a holler. But no police officers, please.
That's true. I smell bacon.
This is the long, flabby arm of the law. Okay, promise us the last one.
Yeah, that was for the ultra premium subscribers. We got tiers, all right? It just depends on what you care to spend.
Yeah. I think I was talking to Jess about this earlier. I feel like my fucking school at the time all had, like, those, like, crazy colored IMAX. Like, there's a fucking, like, blue one and an orange one, and you can see through them. And, like, I don't know, it was dope. I was like, this is cool. I want an iMac. It's thus started my love affair with Apple, I guess.
Yeah, I remember that. They were the cool computers. and there was, like, they were the, you know, one per entire table of old Apple IIe's, and then the one on the end would be the new iMac.
And now, like, RetroTech is cool again, so, or whatever. So, like, people want those old-ass little Apple IIs that look like little Keurigs, you know,
yeah,
like
with
the
floppy.
Early 90s. Yeah, with a Magnum floppy.
Oh!
taking it back.
There you go.
Check out the 92 episode. what else happened? Oh, there's, like, a lot of computer stuff.
Yeah.
Microsoft released Windows 98 that year, too.
Yeah, the competition. The yin to the yang.
What else? Google was founded in September of 98, thus starting their brainwashing and military taking over the world.
Yeah, I feel like I started using Google, I think, probably this year. What was the one? I can't even remember.
I was using Alta Vista.
Damn. Okay.
Yeah. I was using Net Zero because it was free.
Hell yes. Yeah. That's at my grandfather's house. Yeah. Net Zero.
Oh, and Ask Jeeves. And then I would ask Jeeves ridiculous questions.
Such as?
Is Bill Clinton a adulterer?
Yeah.
Things a 10-year-old asks.
Yeah. Blue dress.
Yeah. Next question is blue dabba dee dabba da.
Oh my God. When that came out, like, that was fucking over and over and over and over.
You want to paint everything blue? You want a blue house with a blue window?
Yeah, I am a blue man with a blue bride, or what was it? I can't remember the lyrics.
Like, man. All of my life.
God, those people are fucking... It's like a nihilistic song, right?
Yeah, it was definitely about either the end of the world or foreshadowing a future Arrested Development character. Who's to say?
Yeah, I hope they're doing well now. Yeah, exactly right. Did they move on to that stage show in Las Vegas?
Yeah, exactly. Oh, the Blue Man Group, yeah.
Yeah. I assume.
Yeah, I think that's when the band broke up and they had a rebrand.
So speaking of music, this was a fucking insane year for music. Music has been one of the narrative threads through my life. Got into a lot of good music this year.
I was still recording everything off our boombox, like in the living room, and you would have like a bunch of cassettes ready, and like you would sit there, and like when your song would start, or you heard like the radio jockey getting ready to cue it up,
yeah.
You're like, yeah, and you would make your own mixtape.
Yeah,
I was still doing that.
Recording stuff off the radio.
Yeah.
Off the radio.
Yeah. Now the romance is gone. No one makes mixtapes for each other anymore.
And do you remember it was sort of like I remember like recording over old, like my mother's is like she's like she would give me
her wedding video.
No, man. The audio recording. She recorded everything like Richard Nixon.
Yeah.
But do you remember, like, she gave me some cassette tapes I could use that she didn't want to listen to anymore? Like, actual music, and then you would just, like, put a piece of tape over that?
Yeah.
Or you would break the tab off? You would do
something. That was the coolest part, is, like, it literally was already, like, a formatted piece of, like, a cassette. But, like, you could life hack it, and now you could record shit over it.
Yeah. So, like, you would go from those, and it was just, like, a 30-minute or whatever, and, like, it was, like, for me, a real rite of passage where I was like, oh, this is, like, a 60-minute cassette. Yeah.
I just recorded over my dad's, like, Los Plebeyos or La Sonora Tropical or Selena stuff. And Los Tigres del Norte. Oh, shit. Oops. Sorry, parents. Sorry, all of our parents. We ruined all of your belongings because we wanted to listen to, I don't know, Aerosmith or some shit.
Ghetto Superstar.
Ghetto Superstar.
Yeah, I did like listening to a lot of fuck songs in this day.
What were on y'all's boomboxes at the time? What was jamming for Nacho and Jess?
A lot of R&B, I think, that year, right? Like I mentioned, Ghetto Superstar. Irvin Castellanos.
Someone from the city. One of them fake rappers. No, I'm just kidding. Ghetto Superstar. That's the song, right?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that was a big one.
That was just like ruling the airwaves on 104.5 in Dallas at the time, for sure.
Is that what you listened to? What was their nickname?
They are they're just called K104. That's how I say it. Don't look into that.
I'm gonna report this for abusive.
No,
content.
Dude, I've already got the HR complaint. That, like, yeah, exactly. We're trying to take care of that right now.
Yeah, exactly. They're probably gonna be evaluating you for 90 days, so this is a bad time.
I've already been written up.
I didn't know. You don't have to
Denim,
sign that,
by
man.
By Denim Sweats Enterprises.
Hey, listen. If there's any lawyers listening, please. This guy needs a lot of help.
Adam, help me.
But I, you know, there was one tune in 1998. All right.
Uh huh.
It was a good year for music. Like I say, I was listening to Power 102.
El Paso.
In El Paso, Texas. That was sort of my.
How's the tagline? Is it something like this? Power 102.
Yeah, I think it's like, Power 102. Something like that, right?
No DJ noise. No. And then the wacky audio clips that every radio station has.
Yeah. And then they had the Quiet Storm, which was like they play like raindrops. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Oh, shit.
So
yeah, I'm down to check out some Power 102. Go back in time with you.
Let me go ahead and cue this up real quick. I couldn't even tell you what the hell music is playing right now.
Okay.
But this is you know, like certain tunes. Do you remember certain tunes like are ubiquitous? They're everywhere.
Yeah.
So this was one of those tunes, I feel like.
No matter what neighborhood you're in, no matter what you're doing.
Yeah, it's just like, you know, because I did a lot of walking. I was a little kid in high school. And there's certain things like...
Skip at school to this music.
Certain songs where it's like the cars that drive by, all the windows are playing this song.
Bass,
you know?
Just rattling.
You go into the local Circle K and all the radios are playing this song.
Go to the 7-Eleven and tell a guy, hey, Big Gulps, huh? And this song is playing on the side.
Yeah, somebody's CD walk, you know, somebody brings a boombox to school, they're playing this on their little... Because people would do that. You remember that? Do you ever see the people that bring the boombox?
Hey.
That's how I found out about Bone Thugs and Harmony. Somebody brought a Bone Thugs and Harmony CD, and I was like, oh, this is pretty good.
Hell yeah, man. They're from Cleveland, right?
God, I couldn't tell you.
This is from Annie, right? Like the sample or something?
Yeah, and this is before they did the remake, Annie, right?
Right. Oh, yeah, they remade it.
I never saw it, but I did.
So you're fucking around with Jay-Z at the time. Hey, I like this version of Nacho Nova.
Yeah, it's pretty good. I mean, you know, like when I was a kid, I remember like I liked the verses a lot, but I was like, why? And I was like, this sample is kind of annoying.
Yeah.
I get it now, but come on, little kids. I'm just not like a big fan of little kid voices. You know?
No one hates kids more than you.
That's why. Yeah, I got a public vasectomy.
And then reverse, and then once again, and then reverse, and then once again.
Yeah, I broadcasted it live on like Periscope, Snapchat, YouTube.
You guys know the fucking toll that 4 vasectomies take on a human.
Yeah, but you know what? I mean, it was worth it because you got to make a point, you know? You got to make a point.
Yeah, so that you can make a point.
I hope it got across. I hope some youngsters got a little lesson.
So just listening to a little bit of Jay-Z, what else were you bumping back in your, I mean, I'm going to call it a ghetto blaster because that's what we called it, but.
Yeah, that is what they call it. Sort of like how they call that shirt a wife beater, you know what I mean? Yeah. There are just certain
and then
things.
You're like, wait, I don't know about like, this.
Ghetto and wife beating.
Wife beating.
Like, I don't know about these terms.
Yeah.
But 98, Jesus Christ. I was listening to a lot of R&B in, like I say, El Paso, Texas from Power 102. So, Jessica, what is a standout? What is something you remember from 98, the year that we're currently in?
Let's see. The Boy Is Mine by Monica. I always thought that was a Destiny's Child song.
Oh, shit. I want to hear it. Is that the one that's like, this boy is my property? That's probably a different song. If your status ain't hood. No, I'm just mixing songs.
I think you're writing a song.
I'm blue dub. I'm just kidding.
Okay, so let me go ahead and cue this one up.
This is Boy Ain't Mine by Monica.
The Boy Is Mine.
The Boy Is Mine.
They take an element of a song that Paul McCartney and Michael Jackson did. Like, they did a song called The Doggone Girl's Mine? Wait.
This is Brandy.
Dudes, yeah, ooh. I know that. I said I'd take an element of another song. Oh, speaking of...
this is dope.
1998 sex symbols, you know what I mean?
Monica?
No, Brandy. And Lola Bunny.
This is bumping. Yeah, Lola Bunny. This is pretty dope.
They play this all the time. Destiny's Child, did they start at this time?
It was around there. Yeah, it was 98 or 99 for sure. But they're little babies.
God, yeah.
They're Destiny's children.
Destiny's zygotes.
Yeah. Destiny's gleaming.
So I know this particular song isn't really up anyone's alley, at least in this room, I don't think. We are patriots, but I think...
I like it. I would listen to this now, but yeah, I don't... It's, you know what, it fits the 98 vibe, I feel.
No, that particular
from R&B for sure.
That one that we listen to right now, I legitimately like it. But the song that we're about to listen to,
hey,
this one is, like I say, I'm not certain in this room if this is up someone's alley.
Lay it on me.
All right. But this also was a big and like inescapable 1998 hit. I remember this is one of those kind of things. Everybody's car was playing this. This was on every radio. Okay, so this may be the karaoke version.
This is, oh yeah, I was bumping this.
And the first time you touched me. Wait, I don't.
Whoa.
This may be improvised.
I think this is another tab on your computer.
Oh shit. Members only.
You still have 29 days.
Cancel anytime.
Shania Twain is canceled, my man. But I guess not in 98.
I heard some shit going down in 2018 right before we left. Holy smokes. She got into a little bit of a bucket of human excrement this week.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it. You know what? Not everyone should tweet. No, wait. Was it a Twitter? I think it was just an interview.
Not everyone should talk.
Not everyone should think.
There you go.
And the best one, not everyone should breathe. But let's just take a minute to enjoy this. 98.
So let's hope
that I got one for us.
Yeah. Okay. Sure.
I think my version of this shit. Everyone kind of just threw down some good shit. I think the song of 98. Yeah. All that bucket of human excrement.
Especially that last one.
Can you pull up Lauryn Hill for me?
Yeah.
I think this is like the song, the banger of the summer, so to speak. It's definitely That Thing by Lauryn Hill. Yeah. Here on the Denim Switch Podcast. Yo, my men and my women, don't forget about the dean. This is not the most the king. Yo, it's about a thing. Feel real good when your hands in the air. And lick two shots in the atmosphere. Since you were looking for your friend, the one you let hit it and never called you again. Remember when he told you he was about to Benjamin's? You act like you ain't him, but give him a little trim to begin. Now you think you really gonna pretend like you wasn't down and you called him again. Plus when you give it up so easy, you ain't even fooling him. If you did it then, and you probably can. Talking out your neck saying you're a Christian, a Muslim, sleeping with the gin. Now that was the sin that did Jezebel in. Who you gonna tell when the repercussions spin? Showing off your ass cause you're thinking it's a trend, girlfriend. Let me break it down for you again. You know I only said cause I'm truly genuine. Don't be a hard rock when you really are a gin, baby girl. Respect is just the minimum. Nigga, you still defending them now. Lauryn is only human. Don't think I haven't been through the same predicament. Let it sit inside your head like a million women in Philly pen. It's silly when girls sell their souls because of sin. Look at where you be in. Hair weaves like Europeans. Fake nails done by Koreans. Come again.
Also, inescapable. As is the case with certain years, some good movies come out.
Yeah. You know, nothing better in a year than watching a little bit of TV and watching a little bit of movies, going to the movies with your friends. I feel like by this time I was already making my fucking parents go take me and spend like $30 on a hot dog and popcorn and a giant soda or Slurpee and watch some good shit. So I was a little kid, obviously, watching little baby stuff. But what movies were you watching at the time? Did anything from 98 come around or kind of still sticks in your mind? Like, okay, this is pretty important.
God, good question. In the movie theaters, I think most of the stuff that I took in...
Before you worked in a movie theater?
Yeah, before I worked in a movie theater. Most of these movies, I think I checked out at a... You know those dollar theaters, the second run theaters?
Hell yeah, that's great.
It's where I spend most of my time.
First of all, $1 for fucking hot dog and $1 for a movie.
Yeah, and pretty crappy cheap nachos, too. You could probably walk out with like $2 or $3 nachos.
Yeah, and two or three bathroom trips.
It's true. Hey, they have arcade machines there,
but
right?
But look, let's not lie to each other. We all took a giant bag full of fucking snacks. Reese's and gummy bears and chips and I don't know, a foot long sub and pizza.
Exactly. Yeah.
Everything.
Started taking in Subway sandwiches and a can of Pringles. That was
that's a good gimmick. Like, what kind of ridiculous shit can you go take and eat? You're like, you're eating like Italian dinner, like it's just like a fucking whole spread.
It's like a big cotton candy.
You have like the soft serve ice cream machine and you're like pushing it in next to you.
Yeah.
Jess, we're talking about like shit that we would eat at a movie theater when we were
sneaking
younger.
In food to a movie theater.
Yeah.
Oh man, I would sneak in dollar cheeseburgers. Well, I don't think those were the thing, right?
Hey. No, we said we were sneaking in footlong sandwiches.
Yeah, cheeseburgers, but I don't think they were a dollar.
They were like 50 cents at the time.
Yeah, if you want to get the basic one.
Yeah. Yeah, the Happy Meals.
Oh, man. You know, it's like a Pavlovian thing. When I think about fast food when we do a podcast, like, I get hungry.
Oh, we're going to get McDonald's after this. There's no question about it. Actually, update. Whataburger just tweeted at Denim and Sweats and said they're offering us some tasty number one. So we're actually going to Whataburger.
All right.
Is that true?
No.
Hell yeah.
Oh, goddamn.
I'm just kidding.
Like,
it is.
Whataburger down the street. Let's fucking go.
Yeah, we're going. And we're going to tell them, like, hey, yeah, they tweeted at us for free. And we're like, oh, okay.
It's what I'm going with when I show up.
Yeah. No one loves Whataburger more than us.
Last time I went to this Whataburger on MLK, he asked for what kind of meal do you want or whatever. I said, what kind of meal? And he's like, what kind of sip?
Well, yes.
Oh, shit.
That's dope.
Like, some Dr. Pepper.
All right, Dr. Pepper. All right.
My friend from El Paso was visiting that. She was in the car with me. She's like, how did you know that's what he meant? I don't know.
Like, she's like, because I grew up in the 2000s.
Yeah, MLK.
Haven't y'all ever been asked what you've been sipping on?
Yeah.
Hey, come on.
And it didn't come out till a couple of years later, but
yeah.
Sipping on some scissor.
Hey.
Sipping on some sip.
It's fucking codeine.
Yeah.
Shout out to Lean Promethazine. Shout out to DJ Screw, too, from the Lean Culture.
I bought a couple of leans from a dude I used to work with at my old...
Were you drinking lean on the job?
Yeah.
Dope. What's that like?
Not a lot.
Doesn't it like slow everything down?
Just like a handful of times.
Whoa. You just held all 10 fingers up and you closed your hand five times.
I held up four and I was like, that's probably too many. Yeah. So I put up two.
Oh, and now you're only holding up one finger and it's directly at me.
Yeah.
God, HR.
All right. There's no cameras in here yet.
No.
Hopefully they
just
don't
the
install
secret
it.
Hidden camera that Rock Bottom is featuring us on. All right, last one.
We don't need that. Hopefully nobody's got their cameras. I asked that everyone's phones be confiscated before we went into the recording studio.
Yeah, our fucking Nokia bricks. No, actually, at the time it was the giant Motorolas with like the antennas that come out like for fucking 10 feet.
Yeah. Oh boy. Yeah, that was happening at that time. A buddy of mine had a cell phone at that time, and you could like they had such cool ring. You could like personalize the ringtones. I was like, oh, shit, I need to get one of those.
They were all MIDI ringtones.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Just it was just the what do you call that? The MIDI version.
Yeah, it's a MIDI beat. Oh shit, that's copyrighted too. I gotta cut that out.
So one of the things that I saw because I was a Blockbuster head in these days.
Hey, Denim and Sweats movies.
Dudes. Big Lebowski, one of my favorite movies. Saw it at the time. At the same time, I saw another bowling-centric movie, which was Kingpin. Just remember...
Both comedies.
Yeah, remember...
Wait, was Kingpin, like, he didn't have, like, an arm?
Yeah, he was missing a hand. I think it was Bill Murray. No, it was the Randy
Woody
Quaid.
Harrelson.
Yeah, the Woody Harrelson character.
Oh, Randy Quaid.
Bill Murray stuck his hand in like the ball return machine and ground. Like, he made him decapitate his hand.
Oh my god!
Bill Murray was the villain in that movie.
Oh, what an asshole! He just laughed about it afterwards.
Yeah, he was just like a psychotic dude. It was pretty good.
Big Lebowski. I feel like that's a big fucking movie, a cult movie that everyone still quotes or dresses as in Austin.
Another bowling movie.
Yeah,
it's about so much more than bowling. Yeah. Am I the only one who likes that movie in here?
Most of my friends like it, but
I watched it for the first time with you.
And never watched it again.
It was good. It was really good. I enjoyed it.
We're not shitting on it, dude. It's a cult classic. Dude. He's like a classic. Just what?
Well, I don't want to say every man, but yeah. He's just a guy.
A hero.
He's kind of sucked into a thing. He's sucked into the he's sucked into the gravity of a situation that is larger than him.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean? Kind of like we all are.
Oh, the old man, right?
Are you employed, sir? Employed?
He croaks, right?
He has the same name as another old man who was also named Lebowski.
Where's the money?
Yeah, exactly. And so it's like he gets caught up with people, and people confuse him with the other Lebowski, and multiple people are getting confused.
Let me explain something to you. I am not Mr. Lebowski. You're Mr. Lebowski. I'm the dude. So that's what you call me, you know? That or his dudeness or duder or, you know, El Duderino, if you're not into the whole brevity thing.
Yeah. Wasn't Tara Reid in that movie as, like, the heartthrob?
She was. She was the wife of the old crippled man.
Yeah.
And
Lebowski, like, wanted his rug.
Yeah, and she just went missing for a while. Yeah. And they were pissing on his rug.
Yeah.
He just wanted his rug. That was the whole thing of the whole damn
and a rug and a white Russian.
He was just trying to restore equilibrium. So, like, he's chaotic. Yeah. Chaotic good, chaotic neutral. You know what I mean?
He's in the middle.
It's such a good movie. It's like, do you know how when you listen to a piece of classical music, you can hear all these different bits and pieces and, oh, okay, this is really complicated and interesting. Or, you know, some people are just like, oh, this is complicated and boring. But it's that kind of a movie. It's like classical music. It's just like, oh, fucking look at all these different parts to it. And there's so much shit going on here.
Fuck yeah. Well, you know what? Denim and Sweat's homework assignment. Let's watch The Big Lebowski and enjoy it as adults because it's been a minute since I watched it.
Let's do it. So good.
The Coen Brothers?
Oh, Coen Brothers? Really? Yes.
They went on to do, what else did they do? No Country for
Oh, your favorite from 07.
Yeah, there we go.
Shout out.
Yeah, that was a good one.
What else did they do?
Fargo, they did Burn After Reading.
I like Burn After Reading, but it was like, oh shit, they just killed Brad Pitt. Like, shit was so crazy out of nowhere.
That was a good one.
It's like a dark comedy, right? Like, that's kind of their thing, I guess.
Yeah, dark comedy.
You can tell I'm not a big movie guy, but
dude, like, they did Barton Fink. There's so many good movies that they've done. Remember Barton Fink?
Yeah, so good.
All right. You need to make me a movie playlist, and I'll make you, like, a dirty-ass rap mixtape.
Cha.
And we'll just trade.
Well, it certainly couldn't be dirtier than the rap I was listening to in 98.
I know. You were listening to, like, fucking No Limit Soldiers and shit. Like, your cloud is already there.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's a cool movie. All right. In that year, I feel like my favorite movie would have been The Waterboy. The Waterboy came out that year. Anybody familiar with fucking Bobby Boucher from Louisiana State Universities? Like the most abbreviations of abbreviations, like the smallest college, right?
Yeah, like no notoriety,
no,
like,
not at all.
Nothing they're really famous
His
for.
His job is to give everyone water, and then I guess like someone fucks with him, and then they see the freak out and. He's now a football star.
He uses his rage problems to his advantage.
Yeah. No one tried to help him. They're just like, how can we benefit from this guy? We can win titles. He clearly has a medical issue, mental health issue.
Yeah, exactly. It's a funny that they made him the protagonist, you know what I mean? Yeah. So he basically just like channeled his rage in order to the rage that he felt when everybody was making fun of him for his mental health issues.
You know, and it's not his fault. Like his daddy Roberto like left, you know, very early in his life. So his mom basically sheltered him, you know, so he never really got to experience anything besides driving his lawnmower to school every day.
Really, Roberto?
Yeah. I love dropping that in. I always say that. It's me, your daddy, Roberto. He just shows up at the end looking like a fucking fuckhead.
Bobby, it's me, your daddy, Roberto.
Daddy?
You know, I seen you on the ESPN when they was talking about you being drafted by the NFL.
Not going to the NFL. gonna stay in school and graduate.
The hell with school, dopey! Take the money! You and me could be partners! Just like that Tiger Woods and his daddy!
Yeah, he was like some sort of Latino guy. Yeah. And
oh, his father?
Yeah, his father. But he was just a dirtbag, like he's just a deadbeat dad. He shows up because Bobby Boucher is now famous and rich.
Yeah, he's like a
he
Creole.
He just won the Bourbon Bowl.
Yeah, why'd they have to make the deadbeat Latino?
Well, maybe he was Cajun. Well, I don't know.
I hear from Adam Sandler's Netflix movies that he's not the most racially sensitive dude.
Oh. Well, Farmer Fran was a Cajun, right?
Oh, God, I love him because you couldn't tell what the fuck he was saying. And he had pierced nipples.
The cross-eyed guy?
Yeah, no, that's... Well, yeah, the farmer with the hat, and he wore overalls with no shirt, and he'd be like, blah, blah,
blah, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Just have the defense run sprints.
I get right there, Kalai. All right, now, hey. Lead off, eh?
And if he got, eventually they made him like coach, like he was a coach. How are you the coach? Oh God, the water boy's a cheetah.
Dude, that was pretty good. that was a good one.
What else? I honestly, it's not even because it was a good movie. It's just like has delivered like so many quotes that I feel like people still use.
Most alligators are abnormally aggressive.
This is a quote.
The answer to this question.
Dude, Adam Sandler was so young back then. Yeah.
Anyone?
He's just trying to be a good student.
Yes, sir.
Mama says that alligators are ornery because they got all them teeth but no toothbrush.
Your mama said.
Colonel Sanders is
alligators
a teacher.
Alligators are ornery because they got all them
teeth. They cast someone that looks exactly like Colonel Sanders. He's wearing the bolo tie.
Anybody else? Yes, the user.
Alligators are aggressive because of an enlarged medulla oblongata. It's the sector of the brain which controls aggressive behavior.
Did you ever listen to the Adam Sandler albums?
No. So another movie I think that kind of came out around that year that was pretty fucking funny and I feel like people are still either quoting or disgusted by was There's Something About Mary. Anybody a fan?
I'm raising my hand.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry.
I wasn't looking at you. Hearing the cue.
This is for the video subscribers.
Oh, yeah, it's for the video.
I just want to keep it interactive.
Yeah, Denim and Sweats visual.
Yeah, subscribe to us on YouTube, please.
Yeah, so, besides the gag joke with the cum on the ear.
Spoilers.
Yeah. Oh, oops. So it's basically a movie about a woman being so irresistible that everyone that hangs out with her falls in love with her or has a crush on her. And it's literally like at the end it's just a cavalcade of like all these different characters that have interacted with her and are trying to tell her that they're interested. And Ben Stiller is the main one, right? He went on a date with her in high school and he's in the bathroom and before they actually go to the dance together, he gets his scrotum stuck in a zipper.
That's true. Oh, man, that
this
was
a good
scene.
Before transplants, by the way.
This was before the scrotal transplants, which this guy clearly needed at this point. Yeah, because he mangled up his fucking balls and everything and his zipper.
They're weird looking.
It was one of the earliest, craziest, silliest visuals I remember from a movie at that time. You know?
Yeah, oh, yeah, because everyone's like, ah, okay, yeah, funny, huh? He got his, ah, they showed it!
Yeah, that
like, for like a brief, like, 1 second, they showed, like, the fucking package.
Some, like, prop maker or yeah. Some visual artist had to, like, make it look
fake balls.
Looks like putty and chewing gum in between a fly on a pants.
And they made it look like it's all, like, just mangled beyond repair.
Yikes.
Like, how did this happen? How is the zipper above this?
Hey, you know what character they couldn't have from that movie anymore nowadays, though? The mentally
the
ill
brother.
Not yeah. Mentally ill, but mentally, what do you call it?
Yeah, Frank.
Yeah.
Right? That was his name?
Franks and Beans.
Franks and Beans. I remember that.
Yeah, they couldn't have that, dude.
Did you see, have you seen my baseball?
Yeah.
What else? Yeah, you're right. You can't do that anymore.
Well, actually, both of those dudes were kind of pretty sexually entitled, so it was like one of those kind of movies that I...
Also, know. He beat the shit out of Ben Stiller, I guess.
Yeah, that's right. Okay. They were incels.
Yeah. Brett Favre came and stole there's something about Mary's character, I guess, named Mary.
That's true. He was like the Tom Brady of the day.
Yeah. Or I guess you could say the Troy Aikman of the day.
Yeah, him too. That was a good one.
That was a good one. All right. Oh, and before we go any further, I feel like the soundtrack to 1998, the movie, the classic, probably won the fucking Oscar this year. It probably won the Razzie too. And that's the fucking epic Blade movie.
Did it win the Razzie?
Nah, it won the Oscar.
Hey, I like that movie.
Yeah, dude. Kidding me? Daywalker, a vampire, Wesley Snipes, the fresh off the fucking White Man Can't Jump with Woody Harrelson. So Woody Harrelson went on to do Kingpin, and Wesley Snipes went on to do Blade. Good shit.
Toss up, really. I mean, who can really decide between them?
All right, yeah. That's all I wanted to say about that. I just kind of wanted to listen to the music.
from the scene where they're on the dance floor?
Yeah, that one where, like, everyone's in the European shit. Everyone's,
Dude, is that where there's, like, blood coming out of the thing?
Yeah, dude. Like, everyone's like, where am I? And then, like, he looks up and it's like a sprinklers and he thinks it's like a water ray, but it's blood.
I remember that.
This because girl fucking, like, tricked this, like, normal, you know, to come in because, like, everyone was going to start feasting. This was a fucking trippy-ass movie, dude. It was rated R. It was a superhero movie, but it's rated R. They showed a lot of blood and a lot of killing. And, you know, for a fucking 10-year-old, that's awesome. I think the music's about to start. Ah.
Is it?
No. I just want to hear the scene. This is great.
Well, who does the song? Yeah, all right. Well.
Yeah, so that's Blade. Blade the movie, 1998. Blade with Wesley Snipes.
They what a great
fucking
blood.
Movie. Yeah. Shout out to vampires. Before they got all better by Twilight. You thought I was going to go one way, but I went the other.
They get more romantic.
Yeah. I mean, is there anything better than romance when you can't die? Ew. I guess the one time it wasn't cool was when, like, Brad Pitt, like, married, like, a 10-year-old on Interview with the Vampire. Or it was some weird shit like that, right?
God,
like,
I can't remember
He was
that.
Interested in, like, the baby vampire, but, like, they were all, like, 1,000 years old or whatever, but, you know. They were still in their mortal bodies or whatever from when they
God,
got turned.
God, Jesus, that's weird. That's a weird
plot point. Well, anyways, I'm going to walk away from that quit. I didn't explain it no further. all right, man. So we've talked movies. We've talked music. We've talked events. We talked what we were doing in 1998. The only thing we haven't talked about is TV. So as kids, you were going into high school, and then we're in fourth and fifth grades. We were coming home from school and directly watching TV, I would say, you know, as I'm making my Tony's Pizza or something in the oven.
Oh, yeah.
Or eating the Lunchables with the pepperonis on it.
Oh, fuck yeah. That's what's my favorite.
Yeah.
Was that 1998?
Hell yeah. So what were you – anything that you remember that you were watching in 98 as you were coming home from school or maybe on Saturday mornings when you would wake up?
God damn. So TV, like we were talking about earlier, I think I did catch a couple episodes of Wishbone. Dude. It was just one of those after school things, you
what
know?
A good premise. And like, actually, I wish that show still existed. I don't know. It ended this year. But basically, like, the premise is like, you're gonna want to go to the library and read these books. Because I literally would make my mom take me to the library and get whatever episode Wishbone was just in.
That worked.
So I read, like, The Count of Monte Cristo. I read, like, a bunch
right.
of I fucking Don Quixote. Like, I fucking, like, read, like, great works of literature thanks to a fucking show on PBS.
That's
so,
right.
Shout out to Wishbone. Oh, and shout out to Coach, to DeMont, the villain. The villain on Wishbone, he ended up being a coach at my high school. It was great.
Your coach was a dog?
No, the villain, the bully, that was always fucking with Joe, the protagonist, I guess, like the kid or whatever, that Wishbone was owned by. He was like our basketball coach.
Oh wow!
Yeah, and he was actually a dope ass dude, Coach Duffy. Shout out.
That's pretty cool.
So Wishbone, okay, what other things that were ending on that year? Bobby's World, if you guys ever fuck with Bobby's World. Bill Nye, Family Matters, Animaniacs, and Goosebumps.
I don't know if you guys, because I did watch Family Matters. Urkel was a big deal. But
Step by Step also ended that year.
Oh, that was a good show too. The Code Man.
Which one's Step by Step?
Hey, the Code Man. Whoa, oh, Dana Berger.
Step by Step.
Yeah, that's the one. And Suzanne Summers and Patrick Duffy.
Oh, hell yeah. Hell yeah. Oops, that's a gimmick infringement on another podcast. Sorry that's about true. That.
I will send a bill.
To yourself.
To myself.
We got to get it approved by accounts payable, Denim and Sweats.
I ripped it off finance. From the Bone Zone. I heard it there first. Bone Zone, holler.
So, fucking Family Matters, Step by Step, you guys said. I know I was watching Fresh Prince, but it didn't end in 98. It was on in 98.
One of my favorite shows at that time ended Seinfeld. I had started watching Seinfeld years earlier, and this was the last year. I actually, as a 14-year-old boy, I was crying when it ended, like a real...
Holy shit, man. I'm a big fan of Curb Your Enthusiasm, obviously, and I love Larry David, but I'll tell you what. I was just too young to enjoy Seinfeld, so please, like, fill us in. Like, you actually watched it as it was on.
Yeah, they had on the finale night, I was watching in the living room... Jesus, when was it, like 1992 or something when I started watching it? It was just a good show. It was something else other than The Simpsons. You know, there was some good programming.
Man, talk about you fucking must have been a snarky-ass kid watching Seinfeld and The Simpsons.
Yeah.
You had some responses to these motherfuckers.
A real sarcastic dude. real misanthrope.
Yeah.
But yeah, it ended. It was on a good streak. I mean, I had a good time.
Yeah.
But the last night of the day, they had like a clip show. It was like the best of the Seinfeld series. And then after that, it was like a really long finale episode.
Uh-huh.
They'd been hyping it up, but it was like an hour and a half finale.
Can you, for the Denim and Sweats listeners that are unfamiliar, can you tell us kind of just the basic plot of what Seinfeld is and then how they closed off their arc?
Yeah, well, they build it as a show about nothing. It's if anybody's seen It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia, it's kind of similar to that. It's just a bunch of irredeemable people who live together in New York City.
The worst group.
Yeah, it's just they have conversations, you know, kind of like real life. It's the little conversations that you have in between the big stuff that happens.
Okay.
But in the later season of the episode, they started weaving the plots together. So all these characters would have their separate things going on. But at the end of the episode, they'd kind of like dovetail together, you know?
And all like fuck, like do a mangled fuck up at the end?
Yeah, it was good writing. You know what I'm talking
That's
about,
That's good
right?
shit.
Mm-hmm. So, in the, you know, it was like I say, they would all do socially irredeemable actions. Like they sold this, they ruined this lady's wheelchair and they sold her like used wheelchair. And then it later like... The brakes messed up on her.
Oh, no.
Stuff like that, you know?
Oh, God.
They got some guy deported from the country, some Pakistani guy.
Oh, no. They're just not good people.
Yeah, and in the end of the episode, they're making fun of some lady for getting robbed, and then they end up getting put in prison for not helping.
They got put in prison as the show ended?
Yeah, that was the last episode. It was like... it's zooming away
from the trial of Seinfeld.
It's zooming away from their jail cell, and they're having some dumb conversation about the button on the shirt, which was like the very first conversation from the very first episode of Seinfeld.
That's awesome.
So, like, brought the whole thing full circle.
So these people are so irredeemable that the only friends they have are themselves.
Exactly, just each other. Yeah.
Wow, that's awesome.
It was good. It was a good show.
Yeah, I didn't. Yeah, I need to go back and watch it. You know, I think I've. As you hang out at like Half Price or something, you see like the DVD sets for like, you know, a good price. I think I bought a couple of them. So I think I've got a little homework project for myself for
Super
sure.
Super good. Super, yeah, it's on Hulu too if you want to go through the series. We bust into it sometimes just because you can just crack into a random episode and it's like, oh, yeah, this is such a good show.
Bust all over myself.
Yeah, that's for subscribers only.
Yeah, that's the premium version of the
premium
Denim and Sweats podcast. It's Denim and Sweats X.
Triple X.
Let me see if I have the appropriate sound effect.
Oh, there it is. All right, Jess, do you have anything for TV that you were watching or checking out?
Yeah, real quick while you're looking that up, I just remember Family Matters being super crazy because it was a show about a cop in Chicago, but the very last episode, it's like him and his nerd neighbor who turned himself into a robot fly to the moon and they land on the moon. It's like it has no bearing in reality anymore. It got super crazy.
But it also had like racial commentary. I remember one time, right, like where they were talking about, I think, his son being profiled or something. And he was, like, the cop was telling him and he's like, I'm a fucking cop. you know, this isn't right. Like, there was good shit in there.
It
mixed
was.
In between when Urkel would take, like, a love potion to finally get with Laura and turn into, like, I don't know, like a heartthrob.
Stefan Urkel.
Yay! That's so cool. Hey, would he fucking turn into this guy, like, very often? Like, this is an obvious, like, used gimmick?
Yeah, later on, it became very... The show, like I say, it was like a caricature of itself. They went to the moon in the last episode.
Went to the fucking moon. Oh, well, because he's a nerd, you know? Like, it paved the way for Dexter's Lab. Just a fucking 8-year-old kid. Just
wait, man, were you in that writer's room? Let's get some inside knowledge.
Yeah. I went to Hollywood Upstairs Medical College as well.
My Famous Wife, anything that you were watching?
That 70s show, but I don't know if I was watching it like when I was.
But it premiered in 98.
Holy
shit, Mila Kunis was like 14 when it started or some shit like that.
So it's true.
And now she's married to Ashton Kutcher.
Yeah.
As Kevin Malone says. Yeah, that's cool. Now, and he quit acting because he's like a fucking, like, an awesome, like, philanthropist just looking out for child sex trafficking. Like, he literally stopped doing movies.
Is he punking us? That.
No, yeah, it's a big punk. Really? Wow. Yeah. I saw him doing a congressional testimony. It's pretty great.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Can't you just go back to doing stoner gimmicks with Kelso? Like, come on.
Oh, no, bro. He's a rapist now.
Oh, shit, Kelso?
I mean, in 2018, he turned into a rapist. I'm not even... No, Hyde.
Oh, I was like, wait, I just built this guy up and now it's shitting all over
me.
Yeah, Hyde is he's part of the Me Too movement, you know. Denim and Sweats, you know, agrees with the Me Too movement for sure. And Hyde from fucking That 70s Show is a dipshit.
Yeah, that sucks. That sucks for everyone involved.
That 70s Show is canceled now. How will we get our Topher Grace fill? I guess we'll have to all watch Spider-Man 3.
Yeah, or if he's going to be in that new Marvel movie, hopefully.
Oh, shit.
Cross our fingers.
Yeah, he'll have a cameo as the fucking, lab technician.
Or Venom, man. Bring back, he's probably going to be...
They got a new guy for Venom.
No. It's going to be Topher Grace.
And by Venom, since we're in 1998, I mean Spawn. Because it's the exact, like, basically just rip-off character.
He looks like Spawn.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Has anyone ever looked at that? Come, we need the lawyers to look at that copyright infringement. There's been a lot of copyright infringement in this episode.
We're going to have to reach out to lawyers.
Yeah, a lot of lawyers. I'm going to hit up Bob Loblaw or Barry Zuckerkorn. I'm going to take care of this.
Yeah, or the real life equivalent, Michael Cohen.
Yeah. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. All right, that's a good one. God damn, these fucking 2018 quips are amazing. Fuck Michael Cohen, by the way, and fuck that entire administration. Oops, the Denim and Sweat sensors are on my ass now.
Oh, shit, man. HR is going to be back.
All right, let's see. Well, if we don't have any other TV shows that you guys wanted to talk about, let's talk about some Born on This Year Now Alive and some Dead on This Year Now Dead. So, births, as two fellow El Pasoans go, Khalid was born in 1998. God damn, that makes me feel old.
Yeah, me, same here, Jesus.
What do you guys know about Khalid? All I know is he's a famous DJ and he's a Snapchat star.
He's not a DJ, that's Khalid.
There's a Khalid and a Khaled?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's one cool guy and one lame guy.
Well... my vote goes with DJ Khaled then.
Yeah, the dude from El Paso is cool. Whoever was born in 98, that's the good, talented musician.
I'm just kidding. He's the only one that I wanted to bring up that was born in 1998 because everyone else, I don't know. Well, shout out to my brother. My brother, Alex, was also born in 1998.
I think my nephew was born in 98 too.
Oh, yeah?
Little Jacob.
Bleaker? Oh, no, that's Juno. That's your upcoming niece.
Yeah, upcoming niece is Juno. This is little Jacob. He exists. And he's not little anymore. He's a grown-ass man.
He's like 6'6".
Yeah, he's bigger than me. He beat me up.
Yeah, for your lunch money.
Yeah.
And he took your Letterman.
But Jacob, we're having lunch together.
You took him to fucking like CC's?
Yeah.
It's a buffet.
He just takes fucking, what do you call it? He just takes, yeah, a joke. Yeah.
Tokens?
Yeah, tokens. No, he just accepts Bitcoin now. He just tells you to transfer Venmo to him and he'll let you go.
Yeah, it's classic Jacob.
Well, so, dead on this year, Sonny Bono, American singer, former husband of Cher, who had that Do You Believe in Life After Love hit in 1998, I believe.
Yeah, he smacked into a tree.
Yeah, and then perished. It's not just jokes. Like, when you crash your car and explode out, like, it's not a good thing.
It's true.
So the same year he died, Cher had a hit?
Yeah, Do You Believe in Life After Love. Probably fucking for him.
Yeah, she's like, he hit that tree. I'm going to have a hit for him.
Okay, and then just real quick, Frank Sinatra died this year, the famous singer / mobster.
Oh,
what do you guys
yeah.
know? What do you know about Frank Sinatra?
I knew he flew to the moon. What else? Yeah, he was involved with mafia shit. He did a lot of Las Vegas stuff. You know, I mean, it's fine. It's not something that really resonated with me, but some of the tunes, if I listen to them now as a man in my rocking chair,
yeah,
some of those are good songs.
I feel like Frank Sinatra is one of the fucking dudes that probably is very glad that he doesn't live in this age, right? Jeez. He probably had a fucking just obnoxiously bad lifestyle that never got reported. You know, he was probably into some shady ass shit.
Like our famous president, you know, he's probably up to no good.
Yeah. And then, you know, got in trouble with some people in his neighborhood.
Yeah.
Won the fight. His mom got mad.
Yeah. And then they said, you're indicted. okay. And, okay. Hey, guys. Jess, I need you to check Nacho's heart rate. And, you know what? Let's put a pillow behind him because dead on this year, Phil Hartman.
Oh, that is true.
Oh, shit, he fainted.
Oh, smelling salts.
Are you okay?
I got some smelling
salts. I just brought him back up. I gave him a bunch of ecstasy.
Oh, yeah. This is even better than smelling salts.
Yeah, the Blade theme just started playing again. Tell us about Phil Hartman, my guy. Like, I feel like that's one of the tie-in for both of us is he was on The Simpsons. Yeah. He's also just a funny-ass comedian.
Phil Hartman was a 300-foot-tall lizard who was born on the sun.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm thinking of some other guy.
Yeah.
He was on he was on SNL, Saturday Night Live, if you're, you know, if you got some time. So he was a straight man a lot of times. He played Troy McClure on The Simpsons. He played Lionel Hutz. Now in 1998, this was a fucked up Hollywood story, right? I remember this being a real bummer, but he was married to a woman who he called his wife.
Yeah.
And, you know, I really don't remember the buildup to it because I know, you know, when the articles came out this year, there was stuff that had led up to this. Like,
sure.
They had called the cops for domestic issues or whatever.
Yeah.
Or she was on alcohol or pills or something, but
there's also some weird rumor that she was like jealous of him too, or of his success.
It's a little fuzzy.
Fuzzy math.
But she ended up killing him. Right, she shot him, and then
while
she
was sleeping,
and she killed herself.
Fuck, man.
It was a murder suicide. Do you remember this?
I do remember. I remember. Every time I think about Phil Hartman dying, I also think about O.J. Simpson because I feel like it was like kind of a similar story.
Oh shit! Really?
The other way around.
Oh, the murder-suicide?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but O.J. got away with it, yeah. I guess.
And well, she got away with it because she killed herself.
Yeah, we must have quit.
Was it? Yeah, the O.J. acquittal was around this year, too.
Yeah.
I can't remember. Hey, who's to say?
Shout out to O.J. One of my friends, is, somehow extended family with O.J. because he, is one of his, fucking nephews, married into his family. So he has a picture of him and O.J. at the wedding.
Whoa.
How funny.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus. fucking shit. Phil Hartman, rest in peace, my guy. And also rest in peace to Fat Pat, also dead in 1998, the great Houston rap legend.
And Big Pun.
Big Pun died. Oh fuck. He was a player and he crushed a lot and then he didn't
got crushed.
Hey, did Fat Joe die?
No, he's still alive, unfortunately.
Oh, yeah, we went through this.
Yeah. The Terror Squad lives.
How are the Fat Boys?
Oh, God. I just want to see Disorderlies, too. Is that too much to ask? We need that movie to happen. The Fat Boys. My only... I never even heard their music. I just saw them in a comedy from, 1993. They were orderlies at a hospital and got into mischief.
It sounds like a good comedy.
Yeah, it's so 90s. I'm sure the Two Live Crew did the fucking soundtrack. Is this them?
A little bit of Fat Boys.
I like that they use the wipeout noise.
They even recreated the beginning, right? Well, here, do you want to hear some... Do you want to hear probably something... Well, I don't know. What is this? Let's hear this.
This is the Fat Boys.
Yeah, but I don't know this song. I know this song.
Okay.
You ever heard this?
No, but this sounds dope.
This is good.
I want a song like this.
This is in 98.
It's still referenced.
It's pretty good.
Dun 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 dun. Disorderlies. Dun dun.
There's a lady in a bikini on the cover, and she's taking her top off for him.
Meanwhile, they're like wearing like a muumuu.
It's true. Like, yeah, they've all got like pants and shirts on.
Yeah. like 8XL. And like a beret or like some sort of like army hat.
It's a lot of layers.
Yeah.
You got a lot of shit up.
You know, they're the disorderlies. Like, they have to maintain order.
So yeah, that was the Fat Boys. But we digress.
That's some good 98 shit right there.
Classic.
All right, guys. Closing thoughts on 1998. Anything else that came up at all in this year that you want to bring up? Dun, 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 dun.
98. Well, it was a hell of a year. We had a lot of good times. We had a lot of bad times. But the point is... we're back, and if I were to say one thing at the conclusion of this episode, it was something I learned from Jerry Springer during this time.
King of TV at the time.
Exactly right. And what was his little sign-off? Take care of yourselves. Take care of yourself and each other.
Jerry said that the point of the Jerry Springer show was to bring peace to the world.
Jesus, that's so fucking fake.
meanwhile, let's have this Klansman who just found out his wife's cheating on him with a horse.
Yeah, if we got the breakaway chairs on stage, we want to let it, like,
yeah.
Like,
yeah. Just it's put, like they use the same company that, like, the WWF used back then for, like, their just mass production of chairs that they could just break over each other.
It was like, you know, they had the chairs for everyone to sit on, but there was also, like, a half dozen chairs just sitting on the stage.
Yeah,
you know?
Just ready to be broken.
I think I could pick this up and smash
it. Obviously has a groove in the middle that you could just like fucking just, and then Steve Wilkos just takes a chair shot to the head.
Yeah. He had the pads on, so it was all prepared.
The pads, 1998 pads.
But yeah, take care of yourself and each other.
All right, so that's the year 1998 as we remember it. There's some good shit. I want to thank my guests. I want to thank Nacho Nova for coming on and finally picking a year. Thanks, my guy. You can find him at Nacho Nova on Twitter and Instagram. And also want to thank my other guest, Jessica de Santiago, at Your Butt on Twitter. And I believe on Instagram as well. And also, please, of course, follow me at Twitter. And the show at Denim and Sweats. And fuck it, why not? Also, look for You Guys Are My Friends and Eat My Shorts, a Simpsons podcast as well.
Oh, yeah.
All right, it's been the year 1998. Thank you.
All right, let's get the fuck out of here.
Let's get out of here, man. I wanted you to do your fucking, that the character that you showed us. She was funny.
Which character?
The one you started your intro with.
All right, fuckers, let's do this. Fuck faces, you dumb fuckheads, you stupid motherfuckers, you fuckerinos, you fuck buddies, you fuck friends, you fuck faces. You dumb pieces of fucking shit!
What a great send-off. I love it.